Hambletonian, which you'll see on the cassette. And I spent a lot of time last week, spent a whole afternoon down getting the tapes kind of separated because they'd been spliced together wrong at one time, and the first heat was first, and the last heat was second. It was all messed up, so I think we got them in pretty good shape now. Although there's duplication of a lot of heats. Now there you'll see the crowd rising for the national anthem. And right after that, you'll see probably a replay of one of the heats in the Hambletonian. But all these tapes were put together, and I think they used them, made them from two different angles. And instead of cutting them up and doing anything with them, I didn't want to ruin Benny's whole film, and want to keep all this for posterity because this is something good to have. And anybody wants to, will see it at the Hall of Fame because I give up wisdom of all these to the Hall of Fame, and they'll have them all up there to show them on screen. This is what he was talking about. And I'm sure this is, you'll see Ben there on the outside, and that is VOLO song, because in all these things you'll see VOLO song with the shadow on. Now there is the starter stand, and I'm not sure, I think Steve Phillips was doing the starting in those days, and they did have a lot of scoring, you'll see, although VOLO song was a favorite. You'll find a lot of scoring in the races, and the heat after the heat, there'll be a lot of scores. Although it don't show quite all of them, it shows a good many of them, and you'll think they're away, then they're coming back. Now here they are parading for the first heat, and you'll see, maybe notice the first horse there. Yeah, the real position was Polo Song, because he has a shadow on it. And right there, number six, is Worthy Boy, who also was the son of Bolo, Mike, like Bolo Song, and he won the first heat. Now you'll see some of the, what we went through in the old days with the old scoring system. Now you'll see time after time after time, it looks like they're going to get away, and they don't. And somewhere in the first heat, Lolo Song made a break. And he did come on to finish third. Now here we go again, and I think this may be the, see, what might be him making a break there at the rail now. I think you'll see him go on. This heat will be the first heat of the Hambletonian that was won by Worthy Boy in August 11, 1943. I had seen Willow Song race and was great admirer of his. A song race in 42 for it went in. And then what a two-year-old he was, and he was a great three-year-old, unfortunately. Mr. Baker sold him to, or Mr. Strang sold him to Mr. Baker, and they were given an exhibition with him next year. It was during the war, and at Elkhorn, Wisconsin, he broke a leg and had to destroy him. He could have been the greatest son of Lola, because I think he was the greatest trotter by him, and that's gotten a lot of good trotters too. You can see this heat here now. Comes around, and through the stretch you'll see he comes pretty close, maybe somebody coming up on him pretty good, or he's just getting by him, and the other horse looked like he was coming on again, made a break, and I'm not sure. I don't have all my old horse papers down here to read and see who that was. But he made a break right there. You'll see him stepping on the wind by 2 or 3, 4 or 5 lengths. Now, all these races, you'll see replays. I mean, I don't know whether it was the other cameras or whether they used them for the judges. And this is a replay of the... No, this isn't the replay. This is the second heat, but we'll see a lot of replays. This is the second heat, and they're scoring for the second heat. You'll see Ben there with his shadow on his horse. Right behind him right there is Gibson White driving Gordon Gray. Now, they're going to get off this time, and I don't know who that was get off on top. It might have been Hester Hanover with Harry Pondell. She got 6 money out of the race. This is the back stretch at, still you can see it very plainly at Yonkers, and around about where the, before you get to 3/4 pole behind that, they have a jog track there now. And it's just too bad that it couldn't have been kept a mile track, because I think Mr. Levy had the idea that everybody wanted to see horse on a half mile track, but that's shown in Meadowlands that he was wrong, and it would have been a lot less money spent. They could have put that down, made it a little lower, and maybe put stalls in the infield there, and they had a lot more room or parking in the infield. And what might have been one of the greatest thing ever happened with trotting, if they never put a half mile track in there. And now you see them winning that second heat pretty easily. You can see it was a good easy going horse, and the horse that finished second there was now this is a replay of the race. The horse that finished second in the race was Phonographed, driven by Tommy Berry. Set was third the second heat. Now this is just another replay of the second heat. And these are good to have. Somebody wants to cut them out of their tape and make it just a one race would be easily enough to do. But I didn't want to fool with the film, and I just thought I'd put it all on so everybody could see everything, see how much we scored and everything in those days. Now this was the parade again from another angle of the first heat, and we get to see what once again. It might be a little boring, but a person can, if you have a radio cassette, you can speed it up and you want to see it a little faster, or else, as I said, get a copy made and take out some of this. But I would keep the old original one because it does show, as I said, all the scoring and gives people an idea that a lot of people racing horses and driving trotters and pacers today, they never had the fun of racing and scoring like we, like they are doing there. I know I've been in races where I scored 25 or 30 times. Sometimes it scored a lot and you had to wait and go the next day. And this was only in 43, and I think Steve finally got his gate out in 45. And that first seems Steve's starting gate in 36, and nobody seemed to want it. But I did hear Cox say to Steve after 3 or 4 Hambletonian and Goshen. Cox came up to him kind of gruff talking man. He said, Steve, he said, I didn't like that damn contraption you had at North Vannel. But he said, since I've seen it, and got it and started there for Hambletonian with it. I think it's the greatest thing that ever happened to trotting. And I wholeheartedly agree with all the trots that hadn't been for the starting gate would never have been as far as we are today with racing. I said before, this is heat of the first heat. And Seppling was with Worthy Boy. The first three horses in the race, the finish first, second, third, Bolo song, Worthy Boy, and Phonograph, were all by Bolo Mike. So you can see how much Bolo Mike predominated in a race like this. And you have to have the old periodicals and stuff. Can get out your old horse papers now, and old yearbooks, and you can read and read about all the heats and everything. They cover them well in those days. And the first time I get up home to my library, I'll look up and see who that was that made the break coming home there. Probably might have been placed third or fourth, probably. May have been placed back for the net. Now this is a replay again of the second heat. Bolo song one. You can, one of these pictures, you can see the big water tower that's still up behind there. It's off the Parkway now in New York. And those trees are still there. There you can see some of the bungalow back in the background. I'd gone by Empire City four, 5 years before this on the way to Old Orchard once and stopped in there in the afternoon and saw the thoroughbred races. And then they quit racing there, and that's when they bought the racetrack and changed the name of it and built a half-mile track and called it Yonkers Raceway. And then they sent one of these cassettes to Tim so we'll see what went on at his track years ago. But don't forget, in all these races, when you see a horse with the shadow of it on, it was Bolo's on, because Ben told me once that it wasn't when he jumped shadows, more that when dirt hit him, on it, around his eyes, he didn't like, and that kind of stopped it. Now here is the last heat. I'm sure this is the last heat of the Hambletonian. They didn't show the parades, only the one parade. And they did go in and show the replays of that, which you see a lot of horses making breaks, and but they ran and got them right out of the way. But there you see them kind of just beating them up easy. Now you see them coming into the winter circle. Now for years the winter circle at the half mile track was on the other side, or didn't have much of a winter circle, but now Tim Rooney's put in a winter circle, and I haven't been there since they put it in, but I think it's in about this same area. You'll see Bill Strang, who was a good friend of Lalo's, Lars, for years. Especially was great when he got Rose out Raceway at Winter Road and was there every night until he passed away. He lived in Brooklyn, was one of the first people firms, the big train warehouse that would haul horses and vans. They had a big warehouse over there. But there is the, it is getting this. I think that's Len Rubley at the horse's head.